Hey, welcome back to the channel. In this video, we're going to look at the Acura NSX. And this video will look at removing, well, not really removing, but dealing with some of the reflections there, kind of cleaning it up. You'll see here in the reflections on the side of the car, you can see the building's a little distracting. So we're going to clean those up as well as clean up the entire photo for final edits. So with this video, I've done one of these before. It was probably over a year ago. We're looking at the Porsche GT4, and this is another example. I wanted to go through this photo. It's an older photo, but I want to show you some of the techniques I use to, when the reflections are there, how we can clean those up, make them look a little better. So for this here, this is in Lightroom. I'm just going through some basic edits here before we go into Photoshop. So really with this, we're looking at some of the edits, looking at some of the clarity with the particular photo. We're looking at some contrast corrections as well. And it was a bit warm. The sun was setting, but the warmth, probably want to take that down just a bit. And we'll increase the shadows as well in the car and some of the sharpness. So here in Photoshop, we're going to make a a new layer, and this is going to be a cleanup layer for the background. And I'm using a variety of tools here, clone stamp tool mostly. We're just taking out some of the leaves, some of the bigger stones, and some of the other distractions in the photos. Not too many. Pretty clean photo, pretty clean environment as well. But let's clean up these under the car, by the shadow, and here by the garage door as well. This is pretty typical. I'm not going to go through this. We'll just go through this quickly. I've done this in other videos. And the next adjustment layer, this will be to clean up the car. And this will take the majority of the video. This will take the most time. I will be skipping through and fast forwarding, just going a little quicker through some of them. But with these techniques, and what I do is we'll take a look around and we'll start cleaning up some little blemishes. There's a little bit on the tires here. These are very, very small, but might as well clean them up. These little dots here from them being brand new tires. Okay. And we're just taking a look around, see what we can quickly clean up in the photo before we get into some more elaborate selections and cleanup. Here's some of the power lines. We can easily take these out. And on the tire as well. And I'm going to make a selection here with the pen tool just so I don't bleed over into the wheel well itself. Make a selection. This will be 0.2 pixels. 0.2 or 0.3 is usually quite good. You don't want it on zero because it's going to look way too sharp, your selection. It'll just look odd. And there we go. That was an easy cleanup there. And you'll see there are some reflections. I don't know what this is. But anyway, we'll take this out. This is using the same technique. We're making little selections around throughout the entire car. And just cleaning it up using cloning portions of the sky to that. Now here you'll see a couple things on the side. Now there's a couple lights here. This really doesn't need it much, but I want to clean it up to make the line a little cleaner. So we'll make a selection around here. This will just be a quick cleanup. Okay, and we'll 0.2 pixels again. And we're just cleaning this up here. Okay. Deselect that once we're done. Okay, before and after. And moving over, let's take a look on the front. A little bit there. Might as well clean this up, seeing that we're here. This really doesn't need it much, but just looking at this, I might as well make it a little cleaner, making the selection and reflection a bit cleaner. And we're going to sample a portion of this. Now we're going to inverse the selection. I just want to get the sky first. Sample there and get rid of that tree. And we'll inverse again to go back to the original selection. And I'm just using a portion here. That's pretty good. All right, and here on the side, you'll see there's another, there's an SUV. There's also my tripod. You can see some homes that are across the street. So I'm gonna wanna cover all of this. And I'm just making a portion here where I think the reflection will look good. I don't really have anything close, so I'm going to have to back out a little bit. And we'll sample a color and a texture from, let's do it over here, nice and dark. making sure we don't get any of the other portions of the car. We just want the dark black area. And we'll just paint that in. And it kind of came with this cool little reflection here. I kind of like that. So on the top, I want to clean this up. And coloring over this. And like I said, we're just fording through here. We're speeding this up. And a lot of the selections and the cleanup is the same throughout the car. It's really going around with the pen tool, making selections and in cleaning up using other portions of the photo to make it look a little better. Yeah, we'll clean that up. That looks great. I love the front there. That looks amazing. And we'll clean this up, close this off. Same idea, just panning over this. So really the whole process here with the photo is going through, looking at some of the areas that could need some cleanup, making a selection where I think would be a nice reflection, and just cleaning up using portions of the car. And here's a little bit more now. Here's a whole home we're gonna wanna get rid of. And we'll make a selection over here. And this is just as easy as the rest of the photo. Making sure the selection is good and 0.2 pixels. And we'll just start sampling from below here and painting up until we get a bigger selection that we can use. We'll increase the brush size and there we go. So before and after with that, making good progress so far. And now the side of the door, probably the most difficult. It's not very difficult, but it's probably gonna take a little time. It's making a selection around, and we're gonna wanna go down here. And I like that portion, so I'm gonna wanna leave that. And I'll curve around. We'll just close this off, doesn't matter where it is there on the bottom. And same thing, using a color, a texture, and we're just starting to paint this in. You'll see the top still has to be done, but the little keyhole is on the side there, so we gotta take an extra step, be a little more careful. And before and after. And one little portion here, kind of forgot this. Let's close that off, clean this up. And we'll make a selection around the keyhole, and I'm going to want to sample from the left. And I did kind of bleed over into the selection I previously made, but we'll clean up that. And now we'll make a selection around here. And start painting around, making sure I don't paint directly on that keyhole again. And there we go, before and after, looking great. And this last little portion, paint that in. We'll leave the dark, that's the reflection of the rear fender there. Little intake hole. And as final steps, what I'm doing is I'm cleaning up just the bottom here. You can see this happens, this is quite common. You'll see some little water streaks that kind of run down from the doors, and I'll just want to clean those up. So that's just some little cleanups at the end. And really the final thing, what we'll do after looking at these before and after, we will take it back into Lightroom. I want to make some final adjustments. And these adjustments here in Lightroom is just to finalize the photo. I want to darken the sky a little bit. I want to darken the foreground just a bit more. And I'll look around the chromatic aberration, do some lens correction. And these are, of course, whatever you want to do to the photo, but I just want to do some final small cleanups with this photo before we finalize. So really that video is looking at a particular way to clean up some of the reflections when they are in the photo. Of course, use a polarizer if you do have the opportunity. It will eliminate a lot of those reflections, but if you do not have one, if you did not use them, there is a way that you can clean up the reflections to make the car and your photo look a lot better than it originally was. So that's it for this video. Thanks very much, and we'll see you again in the next one. Does search but you stay lost.